Hello there. I know that a lot of you have bought yourselves a Garrett Euroace, and you've been asking me about how you set it up and the settings that I actually use for my Garrett Euroace. And what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you how to set it up and what my actual custom preference is on the five main settings on the Garrett Euroace. The first thing that I'm going to show you is actually how to adjust the cuff, and there's a screw just at the back. Now the elbow guard can be adjusted depending on the size of you and the length of your arms, and all it takes is just to unscrew this screw at the back. You'll see there's a second hole, and all you do is move the guard down, pop on the rest into the second hole, pop your screw back in, tighten it up, and there we go, that's you ready to detect. So that's the first thing. The second thing I'm going to show you is a waterproof cover. The Garrett Euroace and any Garrett Ace model is not fully waterproof, other than the coil head itself. So it's a good idea to get yourself a waterproof cover, and they just slip over like so. And there is a plastic see-through film on the top where you can operate all the different controls on the Garrett Euroace and any other Garrett. So that's two of the main things to show you. Another one is, when you've actually set up your metal detector and when you're putting it together, you may find that your cable is lying slack. Now this is not good, because what can happen when you're detecting on the ground, this will be swinging about and it may detect it. Now to tighten the cable on to your detector is quite easy. Just press the two studs and spin your detector at the bottom section. And once it's tight enough, wait for an aeroplane. And that's you. So that's it. My cable is quite tight, but there's enough slack in it to get to the battery box and to get to the coil connector. Now, in order to set the stem length correctly for your body, just take your metal detector at any stem length. See that it touches the ground at least. And then what we're going to do is we'll take one step forward, and if the detector is at the right length for your body, you should have about 6 inches from the front of your foot to the heel of the detector. Now the Garrett Euroace is supplied with a double D coil. It's an elliptical coil, and it's got an RX and a TX coil built in. Your central point of detecting is right down the middle, right here, as opposed to the whole part of the coil. So your main detector point is about 2 inches down the middle. It gives you a better concentrated signal in the earth. Can't recommend this metal detector enough for the beginner. I have found some incredible finds, including silver buckles, hammered coins, copper bobbies and turners, many different relics. So this is a great machine for the beginner. I know some of you think it's not. I won't say what they think. Now there's another thing I need to show you, and that is the stem adjustment. Again, you'll find there's just these little press-in connectors, and you can adjust your stem up and down to suit your arm length. And there's one also up here, so she can take off, so she can actually split your detector and take the head off, which I'll show you just now. So we just unscrew the coil connection to the main box, and this comes out quite easily. And then all you do is press in the two connectors at the top of the stem, and there you have it. Comes away, easy storage. You can put it in the boot of your car, you can put it in a bag if you take the bottom stem off as well. And as you see, once you've got it stripped down, you can pack that away in any medium-sized rucksack, along with your lunch and everything else you need, your finds pouch, pinpointer, etc. So it's a great little metal detector because it breaks down so far. And you can put this on a plane. I'll get to that in another video. But definitely a brilliant metal detector. Okay, let's go and put it back together and we'll see how easy the controls are on this superb machine. It's almost plug and play. Let's have a look. Once your Garrett's set up, your Garrett should be set at factory settings. But just to make sure, we'll switch it on. Let it settle. All you do is press the power button and hold it for 5 seconds. And when you hear that double tone, that's you back to factory settings, and it's always a good place to start. And then you can carry on, do your different modes, and you can go in and do your custom mode. Jewellery, it cuts off most of the ferrous down in this side. Custom, which we'll get into in a minute, and then you go down to your relic mode, which cuts off just a little, it's the first two notches of the ferrous and leaves everything else open. And you have your coin mode, cuts off 4 of the notches for the ferrous and 1 of the non-ferrous. And then you have your zero mode, which allows you to search through everything, both ferrous and non-ferrous. Okay, let's have a look at some of the other controls and some of the other displays. Here we have our battery display, just there, we've got a full battery. And here we have our depth display, from 5 cm to 20 plus. And that will give you an indication of how deep your target is. In the middle we have the sensitivity. Now I know you'd like to set your sensitivity to its highest level, but when you're in a very highly conductive area, or you're under power lines, you'll get interference. So what you do is, to knock out the interference, is you take down your sensitivity until you don't hear any of the interfering noise, and you still pick up your signal just as loud. Okay, let's go back to our custom mode. Now in custom mode, using this toggle and this button here, you can take out or put in whichever notch that you're landing on. So when you do a custom, and I'll just show you, I'll put that back in. Once you've set your custom setting and you turn off, the Garrett Euro Ace will remember your custom settings, and once you switch back on, it will still have the same setting that you had when you set your custom mode. One of the other features it's got is a pinpointer mode, which is facilitated by this crosshairs in the centre, and you press that button
and the pinpoint comes up on the screen. And once you go over your target, it'll sound off, and we'll show you that in just a minute. Okay, we're in coin mode, and I'll show you how it responds to a Scottish £1. As you can see, you had 2 points of reference there. You had above the notches, you had the moving cursor, and you also had your depth, which is shown on the right hand side. So let's see if we can find the target, and I will show you the Euro Ace in action. So let's see how it operates. As you can see, the cursor appears above the notches to indicate it's a non-ferrous. And on the right hand side, we get a depth indication as well. Now, to pinpoint your signal, so you take your machine to the side, press the pinpoint button, and once you get full strength, then move it back and forward. And where it is on full signal is where your target will be. And your target will be located right there. And that's your target point in the Euro Ace, that first square beneath the stem. It's dead centre where your target will be. Well, I hope that answered some of your questions about the Garrett Euro Ace and how to set it up. I hope I haven't missed anything out. If I have, please remind me in the comments below. If you have any questions, again, put them in the comments below. I'm only too happy to answer any of your questions. I've also got a giveaway video where I'm giving away a large, and I mean a mega large, sauce bottle. Something like this, but this size. This one's going on my eBay account, which you'll get a link for down below as well. So if you want to watch that giveaway video, it's a great video, which you can see here. I'm out in a bottle dump and I find this huge, huge bottle. So I'll see you there. If I don't, I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Thanks very much. Don't forget, if you're not a subscriber and you want to see more videos like this, subscribe over here. Hit that notification bell. Leave me a thumbs up. It really does help. And I really appreciate everybody's comments over the last couple of years. It's been great. Okay, thanks very much. I'm going to leave you with some video and pictures of some of the relics and coins that I found with the Garrett Euro Ace, just to give you a little bit of encouragement. The Garrett Euro Ace is a brilliant machine, and these are just some of the things I've found with the Garrett Euro Ace. And I've found buckles, pendants, horse pendants, silver buttons, bobbies, turners, George III coins, lots of hammer coins, and that little hoard of 3 gaming tokens from George III. So, as you can see, the Garrett will find a lot of really interesting things. I can't recommend the Garrett Euro Ace high enough for the beginner.